PSL Das from Central Coalfield Limited. I just want to share my experience regarding a pilot project we have installed in one of our project, that is Ashoka Open Cast Project of Piparwar area, which is biggest area. The biggest area producing more than 10 million tonne of coal annually. And this project has been installed with the help of Wipro Technology Calcutta. And we have installed GPS tracker in 50 vehicles along with RFID tags. And we have selected 6 electronic weigh bridges, 3 at quarry end, and 3 our railway siding end. And along with 12 number of CCTV cameras installed at each weigh bridge. So this system is running successfully for last 6 months. And based on the feedback we got from this pilot project, our company has decided to implement this system throughout Central Coalfield Limited, covering more than 2,100 tripping trucks and more than 112 weighing bridges scattered throughout the Jharkhand state, and covering more than 156 important locations like weigh bridges and coal stock points, railway dispatch points. So I have a small video films based on this pilot project, and I want to show it.
This will not play. Our camera, and then it goes to concerned weigh bridge. The empty truck is weight of empty truck is taken, and that data goes to our server, and simultaneously it goes to railway siding also. Then it comes to coal stock area, gets loaded with coal, then again comes back to weigh bridge. GPS tracker unit is attached with that vehicle, and after that it goes to our railway siding area, which is about 12 kilometers from Ashoka project, and this is continuously tracked while traveling period. Then it comes to receiving weigh bridge, and this weight of both sides truck is cross-checked. If it is within the tolerant level, then it is allowed to pass. Otherwise, a MIS report is generated along with this deficiency. So after this unloading of this truck, this second cycle is started, and we get at the end of each shift, we get a MIS report for each vehicle, number of trips generated, tonnage of coal transported from quarry to railway siding. And based on the monthly report generated, we pay to our transporter. Because we have got 3 types of transporter
in Ashoka area. One is our own departmental truck engaged in transportation of coal. Second is contractual trucks. And third is a truck for local sale. So we all cater three types of transport we cater in this pilot project. Based on the feedback we got from this pilot project, the company decided to implement this system in all our 11 area and 60 projects. We have got 2,150 tripping trucks and more than 156 important location, along with 112 weighbridge, electronic weighbridge, scattered throughout the state of Jharkhand. Based on the pilot project, we planned an integrated system covering all these three different issues. That first is GPS tracking, second is RFID-based weighing control and monitoring system, and third is CCTV surveillance system, integrated into total one system, and a control center having at each area control office with a corporate dashboard and viewing control center at Darbhanga House, Ranchi. Our main objective was to monitor all the vehicles related to production, dispatch, and sale in different collieries in the command area of CCL to generate various MIS reports related to production, dispatch, and sale to prevent pilferage of coal during transportation, to increase production efficiency and to improve driver productivity as well as to improve dispatch activity. The scope included is all the trucks reporting for lifting of the coal under road sale scheme, all the transporters' truck engaged in the transportation and production of coal, departmental HMM engaged in production of overburden and coal. The technology we have planned to introduce is GPS, GPRS, and Wi-Fi-based instrument for monitoring and tracking of vehicles, RFID-based automatic weighment management and traffic control management for identification and verification of vehicle, and CCTV for real-time monitoring and alerts. The basic communication which we are going to utilize is wireless network like mesh, point-to-point, point-to-multipoint, and MPLS. In fact, we have already installed our wide area network in CCL at the cost of 36 crore by TCL New Delhi. And this WAN network has been become operational for last 2 months. Based on this communication backbone, we are going to implement this GPS and RFID system in throughout CCL based in Jharkhand state. Application comes data server and clients configure according to requirement and application package based on Microsoft platform for data information management and report analysis, control room for each area for real-time view and dashboard at headquarters for real-time reports. Basic communication connectivity is point-to-point and point-to-multipoint link from mines, washery, and railway siding to respective area office, and from respective area office to corporate offices through our dedicated MPLS link. This is how the RFID tag identification is done at each weighbridge. The truck with the RFID tags comes to the weighbridge. The RF reader reads the tag and a boom barrier opens after getting the green signal. Then GPS tracker truck then moves throughout our railway siding zone area with this link, GPRS link, and the data is stored in the server. The normal process flow diagram is same as it was in our pilot project. The, all the vehicles are first given a RFID tag. RFID tag is having a serial number, and in serial number all the basic data of that particular truck is incorporated. Owner's number, vehicle number, and type of, whether it is contractual vehicle or a departmental vehicle or it relate to local sale, it is defined in serial number of that tag. After getting the tag, the vehicle is allowed to pass, to come to the weigh bridge of quarry end. And at the quarry end, first the empty truck load is taken. After identification by this RFID reader, the boom barrier opens and the vehicle goes to our quarry area, gets filled with coal, then again return back, and comes to another weigh bridge, and the loaded truck is again identified with a reader, and weight of the coal is taken, and it is simultaneously transferred to our server installed at area and unloading point at railway siding. So likewise, this cycle is completed, and we get a MIS report as the end of each shift per day and month wise. And the payment of transporters are being done based on this MIS report. For this, we had floated an expression of interest last year. We got 13 valued offer from all bidding vendors throughout country. And after incorporating their suggestions in our scheme, we placed that scheme before our CCL board at the estimated cost of 48 crore. And this preparation of a scheme, for a preparation of a scheme, we done a detailed survey in all our 11 areas and 60 projects. And after doing the detailed survey, we prepared the scheme. The total command area is 11, and total project offices in CCL is 52, including 7 washeries and 60 mines. Number of vehicle to be monitored is 2,150 presently. And out of this, we have got 557 departmental trucks and 1,593 private tippers. Presently, we have 112 electronic weigh bridge, and estimated cost of this project was 48.18 crores. The CCL board approved this project scheme along with approved cost estimate of 48.18 crore and decided to go in two phases. We were told to implement in first phase, two area has to be covered, that is NK area and Piparwar area. These two is very biggest project of CCL, covering 50% of total annual production of CCL. And in next phase, remaining all areas. So our implementation schedule is, the final NIT was prepared in November 2013, tender was floated in November 2013, and the tender has been finalized on in May 2014. Now we have placed this our total scheme at before our CCL board, and we are expecting final approval from our board at the end of this August, and hopefully we'll be able to give a detailed work order at the end of August only, at the cost of 36 crore, covering more than 2,000 vehicles and 112 electronic weigh bridges. So based on the pilot project, we have done some modification in our final scheme, because the actually the positioning of the RFID tag was creating a lot of problem during our installation period. Wipro people have to done a lot of exercises for fixing the trucks, because we are operating different kind of trucks. Some trucks are different make, our trucks are different make, contractors' truck are different make. So depending on the trucks, their wind glasses are at a different level of height. So RFID tag has to be repositioned in each case. So all this exercise took about 2-3 months. Now that has been finalized, and the our pilot project is working successfully in Ashoka project of Piparwar area. And based on that feedback only, we have decided to go in full-fledged in covering all 11 areas of Central Coalfield Limited at the cost of 36 crore.